Hey everyone, this is John Anthony.
I'm Angelica.
And I'm Regina. We are the host of JAR Radio on Fishbowl Radio Network.
Check out our show every Tuesday from 5 to 7.
JAR is jaded and ready to take on the world.
You will hear from upcoming artists, businesses, athletes, and more.
Don't miss JAR Radio
on FishbowlRadioNetwork.com. Jump in.
JAR Radio is live with John Anthony, Angelica, and Regina.
And we are live now here on JAR Radio on this fine Tuesday afternoon, June 2nd, the first of the summer. This is your host, Regina Frega, and I'm in the studio with
Angelica
and John Anthony.
And we have two special guests in the house today. They are PaulHolland. Hi, Paul.
Hi, Regina.
How are you doing today?
Pretty good.
Awesome. We are pleased to have you here. And we also have Jonathan Blackmon in the house. Hi, Jonathan.
Yep, nickname Full Blast.
Full Blast in the house. And these two gentlemen are representing Special Olympics. And we are so Special Olympics of Texas, right? SOT.
SOTX.
Yes. Oh, I'm sorry. I forgot the X. So we're really blessed to have them here in the studio with us live today. They're going to be co-hosting with us and just having a good time. We've had a lot go on this past week, and we want to share that with you. And we have a bunch of things coming up, and we're looking forward to that. So, Angelica, why don't you give us a recap of what we did last week?
Well, we did talk about our health and wellness that we've kind of been involved in, as well as Regina. She got started with Advocare. I think today is day 8.
Yes.
Yep, that's verified. Day 8 of Advocare. Also, kind of corresponding with that is the two bicycles that are going to be given out by Advocare representative, Mr. Adrian Lopez. That's kind of via through Facebook and also here. We're going to talk more about that here later today. But we also had spoke about our new business adventures and expansion with our office. That's been really exciting. I know we've kind of really enjoyed that and, you know, maybe gone a little bit overboard, staying almost till midnight a couple times. But it's been fun. It's been really fun.
So this week, as we said, we have our two gentlemen talking about SOTX, which is Special Olympics of Texas, and they're going to be sharing their experiences and talking about themselves in the second hour of this show. And we are going to be having two questions. We're going to have one at the half hour at 5:30 and at 6:30 of health and wellness, which will give you an opportunity to have a chance to win one of two bikes. We told y'all that we would be giving y'all more information on that, and you can go to our JAR PR Services Facebook page, and it has all the details there. What we do is every day at 1 and 6 o'clock, we'll be posting a health and wellness question, and the first person to answer that question will have a chance and an opportunity to win one of the bikes, which we will draw here in the studio live on June 23rd with Advocare representative Adrian Lopez. So that's going to be really fun and exciting. So the more questions you answer, the more opportunities you'll have to have a chance to win the bike on the 23rd, and that's going to be really fun. I'm excited about that, aren't you, John Anthony?
Yeah.
So when are you going to be starting to get pumped like Adrian?
When I'm 30.
And we are so excited to have John Anthony back in the studio. Round of applause for him. So let's go ahead and jump in. Let's go into our round table. Paul, why don't you start us off on the round table? What's going on? I know you're a big sports buff. And you always know all the facts.
Yeah. What about FIFA?
Yeah, what's going on with FIFA?
It was terrible.
What's going on? What's going on with Sepp? What is his name? Sepp Blatter?
Mm-hmm.
What's happening?
He did some wrong things.
What did he do? Because I haven't had a chance to like read on it. Just like a brief synopsis.
Money.
He's laundering money?
Yes.
Oh, my goodness. Another money launderer. That is no bueno.
He had to pay $10 million yesterday.
$10 million? Is that true?
Yes.
Oh, my gosh. What do you think about this?
Soccer is a complete mess.
Is it? Are you a soccer fan?
My cousin is, Elliot.
Oh, is he? Shout out to Elliot, Jonathan's cousin.
Yeah, Elliot Gangliff. He likes soccer.
Oh, so I take it you're not a soccer buff?
Not as much.
I think I like the soccer eye candy. My bad. Nothing. I know about soccer only because of my little girl over here, Angelica. She's always been in soccer.
I used to watch her play sometimes.
I know. Remember that, Paul? Y'all used to be fans out there in the audience with me.
Yes.
Cheering Angelica on. Hecka. Go, Hecka. Go, Hecka. Go, go, go. Go, Hecka. Anyhow, moving right along, what were you going to talk about baseball? What's going on in baseball? I know that you're a big baseball fan.
Down the road from here.
Uh-huh.
A 20-year-old named Joey Gallo is going to play his first game ever tonight.
Joey who?
Gallo.
Gallo?
With the Rangers.
Oh, wow. What do you think of that, Angelica?
I think it's kind of exciting. I kind of wish I could be there right now. You know, just go cheering him on his first game. You know? Do you know where he started out from? Where he came from?
He came from Double Lake recently.
Oh, okay.
Out in Frisco.
Oh, see, that's cool. That's nice. And I think that's really cool knowing that someone on a big major league baseball team started out here, you know, nearby our hometown. I think that's kind of exciting.
That's really cool. I think that's amazing. I'm excited about that.
He was he was asked to come here yesterday.
Yesterday? So he's here now?
Yes.
20 years old.
Yes.
Cool. What do you think about that, Jonathan?
Yeah. In sports today, it's all the athletes are getting younger, and there are a lot of new athletes coming into almost every sport these days.
What are they putting in the food these days? They're becoming mutants out there, huh? These kids are becoming mutants?
Yeah.
Do you think so?
I guess. I don't know.
We're going to be having some X-Men on our hands here soon.
Yeah, yeah.
What do you think of that, John Anthony?
It's cool.
So what do you have going on in the world today that you want to talk about?
That Charlie thing.
What Charlie thing?
It's where kids keep on summoning demons at school.
Oh, my gosh. Okay, next. That's We're moving crazy. Along. We're moving along. Okay, Angelica, do you have anything that's going on? And we will not discuss something that's going on in the world today. We're just going to do everything around that. And I know y'all know what we're talking about out there in America. So what do you got going on?
I have exciting news. I can't share with you yet, but when it happens, I will share it then.
Stinks. I do not like that. How about this? I have celebrity news, which I always have celebrity news. So I'm going to tell y'all about this. You know the Backstreet Boys, right?
Yeah.
Okay, well, Howie and Brian's wife, they were actually baptized in the Jordan River a day ago. Isn't that cool? Yeah? Yeah, I think that's really cool.
I wasn't baptized in the Jordan River. Why?
I don't know. I wasn't there when I was baptized. It's like, oh, this is the moment. Let's do it here. And it just didn't. It wasn't the Jordan River. Maybe next time.
Angelica showed me a picture of Bruce Jenner. Like,
yeah,
that
that's
magazine.
A subject I don't want to talk about.
That's
that.
Weird.
Yeah, it's a different subject, and I really don't want to talk about that today.
Well, what about the sinking ship?
What happened with the sinking ship?
One of the vessels blew up.
Tell us about it. You brought it up. Tell us about it.
So there was a ship with like people like touring at this one. I don't know, Chinese place or whatever. And the ship sank and killed like over 400 people.
Wow, that's amazing.
That's amazing.
I mean, that's sad. I mean, that's sad. That's what I meant.
There was actually some really cool movies that I do want to mention, and I'm excited to come out. But there was a Dwayne Johnson movie Jonathan was telling me about.
Oh, San Andreas.
Yes. I really want to see it. Of course, I mean, I didn't have the chance to. Maybe this weekend or next coming up weekend, but it looks really cool. I just keep seeing trailers and trailers. It's now on your nearest theaters or theaters near you, but it looks really cool. I mean, it just kind of makes you think also, because of it being focused, I guess, on the end times. I mean, I don't know. It's kind of, it's serious, but it's interesting. But I'm really kind of looking forward to seeing the movie. What do y'all think about that? Do y'all know of the movie that I'm talking about? What is it, San Andreas, John Anthony?
Yeah.
Okay. Have you heard about the movie? Have y'all gotten to see it yet?
No.
No.
You haven't gotten to see it?
I've seen it on commercials.
Yeah, I've seen the trailers. I haven't gotten to see it just yet, but that's one of the movies. There's also, do y'all like scary movies?
No.
No?
I do. I do.
Okay.
I don't either.
Tell me what the scary movie is.
Well, I know a few people that like scary movies, and Insidious 3.
Oh, yeah.
That's coming out this Friday. It's kind of interesting because there's a couple other movies I'm going to mention, but this Insidious movie is rated PG-13, and a movie that I'm kind of looking forward to seeing is Spy with Melissa McCarthy. Melissa McCarthy, do y'all know who she is?
No.
I can't think of it. She's been in so many movies, but she's hilarious. But she's supposed to be like this serious yet funny spy in this movie that's coming out. I believe it's this Friday.
Oh, is but it that's the one actually that rated plays R. as Tammy?
So yeah, she was in Tammy and a couple of other movies like that. I think she was in one, The Heat, I believe.
Oh yeah,
right.
Sandra
yeah, The
Bullock.
Heat. That was a good movie. What else? Let me see.
Jurassic Park is coming out.
Yeah, Jurassic Park is coming out. I'm really excited for that.
Oh, no,
one.
Jurassic World.
Or
it's not
World,
Park.
You know. Kind of.
Paul, I know you've seen Jurassic Park. The first one, didn't you?
No, I haven't.
You've seen Jurassic Park with the dinosaurs?
I think I have.
Yeah, I think you have. I think I saw it at your house years and years ago.
Did you see it with Sandra?
Oh, maybe I thought you were always with us. We're the trio. The Three Amigos. Have you seen Jurassic Park?
I've seen, the old one. The new one, I have not.
No. Yeah, it hasn't come out yet. Are you looking
previous.
Forward to that?
I'm not really wild about Jurassic Park.
What are you wild about, Jonathan?
I would say, Need for Speed when it came out.
Ooh, that was awesome. We just saw that this weekend on cable.
Yeah, it's... I mean, that Need for Speed is, it's unbelievable. It's like you're playing a video game, but you're actually watching Need for Speed. But they're, doing real stunts. So.
Mm-hmm.
You have the Koenigsegg, the Bugatti, the Celine S7, the McLaren P1, GTA Sparrow, and the Lamborghini. Not the $890,000 Lamborghini, the $150,000 Lamborghini.
So do you like cars? I'm taking it. You like cars, Jonathan?
Yep.
Do you like Fast and the Furious?
Well, I like Fast and Furious except for one thing. Some parts of Fast and Furious, when you go back and look at some of the old ones, they're mostly drag racing. Fast and Furious 7 is not, there's only one part of it drag racing. Most of it is stunts, cars. It's amazing what they did in Fast and Furious 7 with all these stunts where they're jumping off of the cars and all that, and they had these stunt people doing it. Now some of the actors may have done some, but the stunt people that really did it, amazing.
I think we have to give props to stunt men and women, because then there's actors, like you said, they might just show their face because it has to look like them doing it, but I mean, I can't imagine being a stunt woman. I mean, you have to be really fit and know what you're doing, be willing to get hurt here and there. Man, props to stunt men and women. What do you think about that, Paul? Could you be a stunt man?
Oh, no.
Yeah, there's a lot of adrenaline in that.
I bet. I can only imagine. Do you like all the stunts, or do you like, the drag racing, or you like cars, Paul?
A little.
Just a little bit?
Yeah.
Oh, speaking of that topic, yeah, my favorite, motorsports, but I like NASCAR, IndyCar, and Formula One, and the Torrey 9 at Sports Car Series.
Oh, really? I don't know too much about that. I know I've seen NASCAR a few times when I've been over to my Aunt Lizzie's watching with Mr. Paul. You like watching NASCAR races, right?
Oh, yeah, in the man cave.
This Sunday.
This Sunday?
Yeah, he's watching the Pocono race.
Oh, yeah. Cool. What's that?
That's the Adultra 400. That would
this
be
this week's stop?
Yeah.
That's
Sprint
Tell
Cup.
Tell us about it, Paul.
That's a Sprint Cup series.
Yeah, both of y'all.
Well, NASCAR races 36 races out of the year from February to November. Their schedule is long. They have to sign autographs. They do a lot of things. And NASCAR gets involved with the charities. It's awesome what they do with all the charity work they do. But, racing today has gotten where it's very competitive. Your guy could be leading the race, and all of a sudden he runs out of fuel, or let's say this, your guy's leading, and all of a sudden he gets a speeding penalty, and he goes from first to 24th.
Oh, my goodness. About on average, or I guess, I don't know if it's consistent, how many people are actually racing in one race?
43.
Yeah, 43. 43.
Oh, my goodness.
It used to be whatever.
I didn't realize how many people are racing.
Yeah, it's 43 cars. Almost 22 race teams are 23, depending on, I mean, it could be how many it can be, but.
So, Paul, you know what? Uncle James, he builds race cars.
Yes.
Well, what do you know about that?
Well, he builds them.
Do you watch him build them?
No, I don't.
Well, I know that you've seen the races, though.
Yeah.
So you like racing?
Yeah. And he raced when.
Indy racing? Who's your favorite car racer?
No, Uncle James raced.
Oh.
A long time ago.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah.
That's cool.
Sure is.
That's cool. Who's your favorite racer, Paul?
It varies.
Well, who is it right now at the moment, today?
Probably Jess Gordon, I think.
Who? Talking to Mike?
Jess Gordon.
Oh, what about you?
Well, Jeff Gordon's been around since 1993 was his rookie year, and his first start was when Richard Petty retired, the King.
Oh, wow.
When he had 200 victories, but Richard Petty was, his career was coming to an end as far as driving, but he's an owner. He owns Marcus Ambrose is a V8 supercar racing now, but Sam Hornish is driving the Twisted T number 9, and Eric Alvarola is driving the Smithfield Ford in the Sprint Cup Series.
Wow. Who are you rooting for?
It depends.
On what? Tell us, Paul. Tell us. Talk to us.
Who's winning the race at the time?
What?
Sounds like John Anthony.
So you're going for whoever wins?
Yes.
That is not cool. You're supposed to be with somebody and go with them to the end.
Only racing I've seen is Mario Kart.
That's the only racing you've seen?
Have you?
Yes.
John Anthony said Mario Kart.
Have you played it before?
Yeah, on the Wii.
I can say this. NASCAR is, the cars weigh 3,300 pounds. They used to weigh 3,500 pounds, which they're not easy to drive.
Wow. Well, what about Mario Kart? Back to Mario Kart. Who do you play? I like playing with the princess because I am the princess. My mommy told me so.
I think I heard her so many times.
Let's see on Mario Kart. Let's see. Well, I played Yoshi and Toad, Bowser, Donkey.
But who's
Kong.
Your favorite one? You can only name one.
Yoshi, I would have.
Okay,
to that.
Paul. Who are you?
Luigi.
Luigi.
Yeah.
Who are you?
I like Toad.
I like Baby Luigi.
Baby Luigi. So you and Paul, y'all are a team. Y'all are a duo.
Yeah.
Senior Luigi and Baby Luigi. And I'm the princess. Y'all are trying to save me?
No.
Save me. Aren't y'all, isn't that the whole thing of the whole
No,
game?
In Mario Kart, you throw turtle shells to destroy the princess.
You do not destroy the princess.
Yeah, you do.
That is not cool. That is not
throw
cool
in
at
and
all.
She goes to last place, which is awesome.
Yeah, no, I think her cart is actually the smallest and the slowest.
Yeah.
Yeah. I've tried playing as princess once, and that was enough for me. That's why I stick with Toad.
Well, that bums me out. I think we need to take a break. Okay. What do y'all think?
Yes.
Yeah.
Let's take a little quick music break, and we will be back, and we'll be giving y'all the trivia question at the half hour. Stay tuned on JAR Radio. You're on the air. You're live with Regina, Angelica, John Anthony, Paul, and Jonathan. Stay tuned. And we are back live on the air with JAR Radio. This is your host, Regina.
Angelica.
Paul. And Jonathan Blackmon, nicknamed Full Blast.
And that is Jonathan Blackmon, Full Blast in the house. Woo-woo! So now it is 5:30. That's time to raise the question for a chance to win a brand new bike on June 23rd. Y'all be sure to call in to 214-556-6239. And the first one to call in with the correct answer will have a chance to win the bike on the 23rd. And the question is, which human bone is most commonly broken? Again, the question is, which human bone is most commonly broken? So y'all go ahead and call in with that answer, and you will have a chance to win one of the two bikes. So, moving right along, we're going to go into our Did You Know segment. So, guys, what do y'all have anything that y'all want to let the audience know about that we didn't know about?
Well, actually, this is a family question. I mean, a family fact, did you know?
Okay, tell us about the family fact.
We're the three amigas. Gina, Regina. No, I'm the oldest.
Uh-huh.
And my sister Sandra is the second oldest.
Uh-huh.
I think you're
I'm the youngest out of
yes,
us.
Yes.
Yeah, I'm the young one. Y'all remember that. Regina is the young one. Out of the three amigos, that is.
And Regina's mom used to call you Gina and Sandra. Come here.
I remember that. That's cool, Paul. Do you have a did you know fact?
Let's see. I have a couple, but
let's do one right now, and then we're gonna all go around and give some did you know facts. Is that cool? Full blast.
Yeah.
You're going full blast on us.
Yeah. The NSF5 is the fastest street legal car, probably when it comes out, but the fastest overall average was the Hennis F5, which it got considered a Guinness World Record, 270 miles an hour.
It goes 270 miles an hour?
Yeah.
Dude.
Yeah. Cars are getting faster, but...
And athletes are getting younger.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And if you're going to go that fast, go to a test course.
Wow.
A test course, that would be like a place where it's kind of like an autobahn or like a banking that's that big where you can drive on a test course wide open.
Wow. Let's go ahead and move forward. John Anthony, thank you. That's cool information. Do you have a did you know fact? You said you did.
Yeah.
What's up?
Did you know that the song Smells Like Teen Spirit song was actually inspired by Kurt Cobain's girlfriend's deodorant called Teen Spirit?
That's funny.
What is that?
Kurt Cobain?
No, the drink.
No, deodorant.
Deodorant. A girl's deodorant.
I mean deodorant.
I don't know. I'll use it.
It's a I used to use Teen Spirit. I think Angelica did too. I used to buy it for her. They have all those fruity smells and everything. I didn't know that. That's pretty cool. That's cool. Well, how about this? Did you know that 60% of NBA players are bankrupt within 5 years of leaving the league? Did you know that, Paul Edward?
No, I didn't.
You didn't?
Until now.
You know, and he'll know it forever because he's amazing. Oh, my gosh. My cousin Paul is freaking cool, dude. Like, those of you out there that have known my cousin or met him, he's, like, really cool. He can remember a fact, and he'll remember it forever. You tell him it one time or introduce him to somebody or something, he'll remember everything about that person, and He remembers it from, I mean, it's amazing. I mean, Paul, you're amazeballs.
Thank you.
Paul.
You are. You're really, really cool.
What's Regina's birthday?
He knows it.
July 27th.
Oh, thank okay. you very what much.
Year? What year? Yeah, what year?
1975.
That's oh, right. Okay. See? He knows every... Right, Jonathan? You're his best friend. Isn't he like...
Yeah.
He is like a bank of info. He yeah. is cool I like that. You're cool like that, no, Paul.
No, you were born on a 79th.
Oh, my...
Oh, you were?
I guess I was. I was born on a Sunday night.
Yeah.
The last day of the Father's creation of the world. So I'm completion.
I wouldn't go that far. I wouldn't go that far.
Oh, I just went there.
Okay.
Oh, okay.
Did you know that 78% of NFL players are bankrupt 2 years after finishing their careers?
Yeah.
You knew that?
Yes.
That's sad. Like, name a couple of players that have gone bankrupt that you know of.
Tom Brady.
No, Tom Brady didn't go bankrupt.
He is.
Well, you don't know.
I think, let me see. Bosworth, Brian Bosworth.
Uh-huh. Yeah, that's a good one. That's a good one. Do you have any did you know facts?
Yes, I did. And it's actually referring to food. Did you know that the croissant was created in Austria? Did you know that?
Yes.
I didn't know that.
Now you do. And I like croissants.
My history teacher told me.
Warm, buttery croissants. They're so yummy. I like bread. That's my problem. Ooh. But yeah, they're created in Austria.
Cool. We don't have anybody that has called in to answer the question, which human bone
Kevin
is most common?
Which
is commonly broken. Which human bone is commonly broken? I'm going to even give y'all a hint. It's one of these. A hand, a collarbone, a wrist, or a hip.
What is the answer to
this question? Call in with the answer if you know it for a chance to win one of two bikes on the 23rd.
Wait, Mom. Oh, did you know that Hulk used to be gray?
Yeah, you told us that before.
What about...
Yeah, Paul and I both... When we see information, we... I know a lot. Paul knows a lot, too.
Yeah, both of y'all know a lot. I think it's kind of cool that we have y'all in our house right now.
Yes.
Sharing the mic with us.
Let's see...
Did you know that if you add up the numbers 1 through 100 consecutively, it adds up to 50-50?
So if I add up 1 to 100.
Yep.
If you add 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 all the way up to 100, consecutively it just equals 5,050. 50-50.
That's a lie. I'm going to do
Isn't that
right
interesting?
Now.
I think that's kind of cool. I like math, if you can tell.
All right, we are going to go ahead and press forward. That was our Did You Know segment. Angelica, we always have a segment that we like to call... Hold on, let me get this together, y'all. Whoa. Y'all do this.
Espanol con Angelica.
Yeah, I couldn't find the little ding-a-ding-ding-ding. So yeah, Espanol con Angelica.
I didn't know how long the hand tapping was going to go.
I think we need to have an engine.
There we go.
A V8 or V10.
All right, so I have a main word I'll save till the end. But we were talking about soccer, so I figured we might as well just translate into Spanish. Football.
Oh, boring.
Hey, we gotta start slow and then amp it up.
Okay.
The way this works, gentlemen, is that she tells us something in Spanish and we all have to repeat it. So, Paul, go ahead and take your stab at football.
Football.
All right.
Go ahead, Jonathan.
Football.
Uh-oh, what's up?
Football.
No, it's football.
Football. bold.
There you go. There go.
Good job. Good job.
Wait, I have a Spanish word.
What's your Spanish word?
Hola.
Hola. Okay.
We have to start up beginners, like you said.
We started beginners. Anyways, next is to run. Correr.
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 Oh, okay, Paul, you're first.
Go ahead.
go ahead, Jonathan.
Let's see. I'm going to see on this one. See how I do. Correr.
Y'all two are great. Go ahead.
I was shocked on that one.
Can you say it again?
Correr. Oh, that's what's up. Go, Regina. Go, Regina. Go, Cortel. Paul. Go, Jonathan.
Cortel.
There's not a G.
Can you say it again? Correr.
I don't know how to say it. It's weird. Cordell.
Let's say it all together at once. You ready?
Yes.
Correr. All
right.
Sounds like the champagne's not Corbell.
It does.
All right. I have another one. It's sailing. Navegación.
Oh, God. Navigation.
When I saw this, I had to say it only because, I mean, I knew you guys were coming, and I noticed that the Special Olympics of Texas, they have out in California this year. I don't remember exactly when, but they have competitions for sailing and something else. I was like, ooh, I wonder what that is in translation. And it's navigación.
Navigación.
It kind of sounds like navigation, which sailing, you know, is kind of navigating. But navegación.
Navegación.
There you go. Navegación.
Go ahead.
Go, Jonathan.
I was thinking Lincoln Navigator, but. let's see. Navigation.
There you go. There you go.
Put navegación.
There you go.
Navegación.
No, you didn't.
Yes, I did. You ready? One, two, three. Gentlemen, go.
Navigación.
Navigación.
Okay.
One more.
Oh.
I have one more.
This is getting hard.
One more. And this is just because of you guys. We love you so much. Special Olympics.
Oh, gosh. This is going to be hard.
Oh, no. I'm scared.
Olimpiadas.
Olimpiadas. Peace out.
Oh, there you go. He beat me to the punch.
Go, Paul.
What was it, Paul?
Olympicas.
Olympiadas.
Olympiadas Special.
There you go.
Okay, come on, Jonathan. Take a stab at it.
Olympic Cassian.
How do you say it?
Olympiadas. Olympiadas.
Olympiadas Espiales. Espiales?
Olympialas Espale.
John Anthony, good job. Try it again, Jonathan, and then I'll try it again.
Olympiatic.
That's good. You did good.
Yeah, that sounds like
a mouthful.
All
right. It is a mouthful. Olympiadas Espiales. You ready? All together.
Olympiadas
Espiales.
Olympiadas Espiales.
There
you go.
He says it good. Go, Paul. Go, Paulito. Go, Paulito.
Okay.
Hey. Go, Paulito.
All right. That was it. That wraps up our special Español con Angelica for today. So, that's it.
Are you going to review all the words real quick?
Mm-mm.
Yeah, review them.
No.
Oh,
man. Put me on the spot. Okay, we have, the first one was soccer, football, then we have to run, correr, and then we have sailing, which was navegación, and Special Olympics, Olimpiadas Especiales. And those will actually be on our Facebook page, facebook.com/JARPR, or JAR Radio, JAR Tune In Radio. Forgive me. JAR Tune Radio. It'll be on our notes on our page.
Yay. Thank you.
I've got one. In motorsports, it would be called Deportes Motors.
The Portes Motors?
Is in motorsports in Spanish.
Oh, good job, Jonathan. Good job. Go ahead. What's your did you know fact?
Did you know Kurt Cobain dropped out from his high school and then went back to his
high
school?
Okay, first, let's make sure that our guests know who Kurt Cobain is. Do y'all know who Kurt Cobain is?
Yeah,
a singer.
Do you know of what group?
The Backstreet Boys.
What?
You're so cute, Paul. I can't help you, but spot. He's from Nirvana. Yeah, Nirvana. You're so cute. That's one of John Anthony's favorite groups and artists. So when he keeps talking about Kurt Cobain, that's who he's talking about. And to all of our audience, that's who he's talking about.
Yeah, but he dropped out from his high school and then went back to the work as a janitor.
Embarrassing.
And that's how he met Dave Grohe and that Chris dude.
Oh, and those were his bandmates, correct?
Yeah.
Awesome. So,
And they made Foo Fighters.
Yep, that is cool. That is so cool. So, we are going to be going into a song, and then it's going to go into our commercials so we can pay some bills. And then at that point in time, we'll be coming back, and Angelica is going to give us the music that's coming out, and then we're going to go into our interview with these fine gentlemen that are here from the Special Olympics of Texas, Paul Holland and Jonathan Blackmon. So we're really excited about that. We're excited to get to know y'all better, to get to know this organization that y'all are a part of, and we're going to let y'all tell everybody on how they can get involved and, you know, what they can do to support y'all. So we are going to be taking a quick break. Y'all don't go anywhere. Y'all stay tuned and be sure to call in. Y'all can call in during the break, 214-556-6239. And y'all can also call in if y'all have any questions or shout out to give to these two gentlemen. Y'all can call and talk to them live on the air. You can be on the radio. Let everybody in the world get to hear you because we are international. So we're being heard all over the world right now, not just in the U.S. or in Dallas, Texas, all over the world, because that is what Fishbowl Radio Network is all about. So y'all stay tuned and we'll be back, and you'll be back live on the air with JARR Radio. Jump in.
You are live with JARR Radio on Fishbowl Radio Network. Jump in.
Hi, this is Regina with JARR Radio, and we have a special guest that has called in. It's Jim. Hi, Jim.
How are you?
We're great. How about you tell us where you're calling from and who you are and all that good stuff?
Well, my name is Jim Dahmer. I am the head of delegation for the Louisville ISD Special Olympics.
Awesome.
And you have two of my favorite athletes on the radio.
And they're ours, too. Thank you for calling in. Do you have any questions for them?
I do. I just want to know, what is it that they like most about Special Olympics?
The state games.
The being with sponsors and the athletes.
And so, how long have each one of you been involved in Special Olympics?
Me, 25 years.
That's Paul.
23 years in Special Olympics. Since 1992 in this state.
Awesome, and that's Jonathan.
That's a long time. And in those years, both of you, what has been the highlight of all those years you've been involved in Special Olympics?
Me being the male athlete of the year in 2011 for SOTX?
I would say the 2003 Torch Run's one of them, and also being the athlete of the year for 2014 into 15, and the Big 12 Athlete of the Year. That is awesome. Got to go to the Sprint Center and the Big 12 Phillip 66. They had the Big 12 Championship game. It was cool. At the second half, with 18:59 to go, they presented us with this Big 12 ring. It looks like a Daytona 500 in a Super Bowl ring.
That's awesome.
What is you guys' favorite sport?
Bocce ball.
Mine's is long distance running.
Long distance and bocce, boy, I tell you. Yeah, you guys have been around a long time. What advice would you give to other Special Olympics athletes that want to join Special Olympics?
You have to be 12 and older to go to the state games.
Do you have any advice for them, Paul?
Oh, advice. Train hard.
I like that.
Yep. In today's sports world, there's a lot of sports drinks now, and a lot of them are now zero calorie or G2 or Powerade Zero or All Sport or something like that. But, yeah, train hard because it will be getting more competitive in the future for sure.
That's great advice.
Is there anything that has helped you outside of Special Olympics by being involved in Special Olympics, like out in the, you know, in the city, in a job, or any of those types of things?
I worked at Blockbuster almost 18 years.
Let's see, I worked at Harlan Mifflin Hardcourt for 11 years, and it was a warehouse.
Wow, that's awesome.
Pretty good.
Mm-hmm. So, do you have anything else?
I'm kind of out of questions for you two, but sounds like you guys love Special Olympics and do a very good job.
Yes, they do. Thank you so much for calling, Jim. And
no problem.
Yeah, we appreciate it, and we appreciate you giving these gentlemen a call. Thank you.
All right. Have a great afternoon.
You too. Y'all say bye.
Right, bye, Coach.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye, guys. Bye.
Well, that was a cool call, guys.
Thank you.
Y'all are so awesome. I love that.
You're famous.
Yes, they are. They actually are out in, yeah, they really are, actually. So, like we said, when we'd get back, we were going to have Angelica do her, she has another segment that she does, and that's giving us an update on what's up and coming in the music world, which is Jonathan's favorite. Just playing. But she's going to give us what's coming out and all the new music and movies. And then after that, we're going to go into our interview with these two gentlemen. Hold on one second. Go ahead. Take it over, Angelica.
All right. So I am going to list. I actually haven't done this segment for a little while. So I'm going to list not only new songs that came out today or this past weekend, but what came out here a couple earlier this, I say this month, but it's already June 2nd. A couple that came out earlier May. I haven't done it that far back, so I kind of figured I'd throw a couple of those in there. One of them, the first one is Phenomenal. That actually released and came out today by Eminem. I like Eminem, you know, famous rapper. That's actually coming up also because he is supposed to be working on a new album, so I'm kind of looking forward to that. Second, I have Third Eye. Do y'all know Florence and the Machines?
Yes.
No? No?
Yes.
Well, Florence and the Machine came out with a song called Third Eye. Third Eye is actually kind of really almost like intense and serious, but it's really catchy too. Then we also have On the Wire by Air Traffic Controller. Do y'all know who they are?
No.
To be honest, I didn't know either until I saw the song that was new. And they're actually not a bad band. They're actually kind of good. I like them. We also have Powerful by Major Lazer featuring Ellie Goulding. I love her.
I do too.
I really like her. And she's like one of the first voices you hear in the song. And it's actually a powerful song to be powerful. All right. And then we have a song called Together by Kazette featuring New Timers. I've heard of Kazette before, and I say that way because it's actually spelled with Z, C-A-Z-Z-E-T-T-E, all caps, but they're a DJ group and more of an electronic, kind of like Skrillex and stuff. They have really cool songs, and that's a newer one called Together. They have Trade Hearts by Jason Derulo. He released a lyrical video on YouTube via Vivo. I think I pronounced it right. Vivo?
Yes.
Yeah, Vivo, featuring Julia Michaels. We have Your Mind by Lola Marsh, Bad Girls by MKTO, Children of the World
by Steve Angelo. Seesaw by Jamie XX featuring Romy. And Reapers by Muse. I like Muse. Do y'all know who Muse is? Do you like him?
Yes.
No.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Well, Muse came out with a song called Reapers on a newer album that's coming out soon, too.
I don't know if I should listen to
that. That's all I got.
Cool, that was really cool. So I'm excited about that. Are there any upcoming movies that you guys are wanting to see?
Yes.
What is it? Just give
Jurassic
us one.
Jurassic World.
What about you, Jonathan?
The next one, well, I mean, there'll be some movies I like, but if I was talking about like just car movie in general or cars or sort of that sort of movie, Cars 3 is what I'm looking forward to because the Bugatti Veyron might be in there.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, the Bugatti Veyron's in the Transformers, Need for Speed, and Fast and Furious 7.
Wait, awesome.
Wasn't the Bugatti the bad guy in Transformers 4?
I think he was actually a good guy because he was with Optimus Prime. So.
Oh, well, then he'd have to be a good guy. I'm Optimus Prime, by the way.
No, you're not.
That's the Transformer I am.
I'm Galvatron.
I'm Optimus Prime. Paul, yeah. What movie are you looking forward to seeing?
I don't have any particular one.
Oh, okay. Well, you know what, guys? I think I want to get into talking to y'all about y'all. How does that sound? Can we start interviewing you?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. So, Paul.
Yes.
What organization is it that y'all are representing for people that are just now tuning in and haven't heard already? What organization is it that y'all are representing here today?
Special Olympics Texas.
All right. And how do you abbreviate that?
SOTX.
That's right. Don't forget the X, like me. So how long, again, have you been a part of the Special Olympics Texas?
25 years.
25 years.
Wow. Since 1990.
Since 1990.
I was 16 years old when I started.
Wow.
Before I was born.
Yes. Yeah, that was before John Anthony was born.
And Angelica.
Oh, yeah, and Angelica. Oh, my goodness. But you look so great. You look so young.
Thank you.
So that's in our genes because we look young.
Yes.
Yeah. We can thank our grandma for that one.
Yes.
Rest
yes.
in peace, grandma. Okay, Angelica.
What activities do you participate in the Special Olympics Texas?
Bocce ball and bowling.
What's bocce ball? I've honestly never heard
of it. It's bowling on grass.
Oh, I played that then.
Oh, okay. I think I know what you're talking about.
Bowling on grass, yes.
Okay, and which activity would you say is your favorite?
I think bocce ball.
Okay. All right. I mean, I think I can see that. You know, you're outside.
It's hot.
We are in Texas, you know.
Yes, definitely, yeah.
Yeah, cool. Yeah, my sport is running and golf.
Okay, we'll get let us interview Paul Edward first and then we're going to get to you. Yeah. And you're going to have you can tell us all about your stuff. Is that okay?
Yeah.
Okay, thank you. Okay, go ahead, John Anthony.
You're also known as Mr. International in our family.
Why don't you tell us? Mr. International.
Why don't you tell us some of the places you've been able to go?
I've been to China twice, 2006 and 2007.
Wow.
2007, I went to China and did the World Games.
That is so awesome. And where else have you been?
London with Jonathan.
That's cool.
And Ireland.
Ireland?
Yes.
Wow. Oh, yeah. You know what? I have a cross that Aunt Lizzie, your mom, my Aunt Lizzie. If everybody doesn't know already, Paul Edward Holland is my cousin. It's our cousin. And his mom's my Aunt Lizzie. Shout out to my Aunt Lizzie, my beautiful aunt.
Hi, Aunt Lizzie.
Hi, Aunt Lizzie. And my beautiful cousin, Sandra Renee Hernandez. Or Muselli.
Muscle.
It's Muselli.
Muscle. I said muscle too.
She says you have to say it right. It's Muselli.
It looks like muscle.
But it looks like muscle. Anyway, we're getting off track. Okay, let's go back to Paul. It's all about Paul right now.
Okay.
It's all about Mr. International. My whole point was is that my Aunt Lizzie got me this really cool cross. I think she got all of us one from Ireland. It's really cool. So.
Is that the circle in it?
Yeah, the circle.
It looks like iron.
It's the one that you broke that I'm having to glue back together. Yeah.
I broke it.
Yeah.
When?
Yeah. So let's moving forward. Paul, what would you say is one of the most memorable things that you've had the opportunity to do while representing the Special Olympics?
Being the male athlete of the year in 2011.
In 2011. And so why is that? Why would you say that that's one of the most memorable things? What was it that you were able to do as male athlete of the Special Olympics of Texas? What are some of the cool things that you were able to do?
Did the athlete oath.
Do what?
Athlete oath.
Oh, and what was that?
Let me win. If I cannot win, I'll be brave in the attempt.
Awesome. Wow, that is a nice oath. I know that also, I know you've had, it seems like there was a picture of you with Joe Jonas or something.
Yes, I went to Washington.
What did you do there?
Promote the Special Olympics.
Yeah, see, I want to know about some of those cool things. So you got to meet, who did you get to meet out there in Washington?
Pete Sessions.
Uh-huh.
Michael Burgess.
Awesome. And Joe Jonas, how did that come about?
Well, he was there.
Oh, so you just got to get a picture with him?
Yes.
That is cool. That was a privilege for him, I bet.
Yes.
Yes, it was, to be taking a picture with Mr. International. That's what I'm talking about. So what does being a part of this organization mean to you?
Means to get a job for 18 years with Blockbuster.
And like, what is you being able to say, you know what, I'm with Special Olympics. How does that make you feel?
Real good.
It does. I love that. Thank you so much for talking with us.
Oh, you're welcome.
And we're going to probably be asking you some more stuff along the way, okay?
Okay, all right.
You're letting us get all in your business today?
Yes.
Okay, so Jonathan, how long have you been a part of the Special Olympics?
Since 1992 in this state.
Okay.
I was born in Alabama. Oh, I was born in Alabama in 1980, and then Mom and I moved into Texas in 1992.
And so you've been part of the Special Olympics since then?
Mm-hmm.
Awesome.
Oh, so you kind of started telling us about your favorites. What are some of the activities that you participate in the Special Olympics, and which one is your favorite?
Long distance running, the mile and the 2 mile.
Okay.
I like the longer distance. Mm-hmm. On the track, I like doing the 2 mile the most because it feels like auto racing, but it's running. That's what it feels like.
All right, and you're saying like the 2 mile running is your favorite? Cool. I wish I liked running. Lord, I need to love running. John Anthony?
We know you have a nickname too. Why don't you tell us what they call you and why?
Oh, my nickname is Full Blast.
Full Blast? And why do they call you Full Blast?
Well, it started back in cross country in Louisville High School back in 1998.
Wow. And why did it start?
Well, main reason because I like to run Full Blast sometimes, but
I like that.
I just like going fast almost nearly most of the time.
That's cool. So you like going full blast. That's cool. I love that. What would you say is one of the most memorable things that you have had the opportunity to do while representing the Special Olympics of Texas?
The most memorable, I would say, going all over the world in 2003 torch run. And
tell me more about that. I knew that you went and you were able to hold the torch. I mean, this is something major. What is it that you had that you actually did?
Well, we went to Greece. I had Mike Sutton as my FBI agent and a couple other police officers and FBI agents and all that who were the law enforcement torch run, where the law enforcement torch run guys were with the athletes.
Special Olympic athletes, correct?
I was one of the 10 athletes in the world let's see, six out of the United States.
Oh, wow. And you, okay, so 10 of y'all were running and holding the torch and got to hold the torch. How long did you hold that torch?
I hold it, let's see, well, probably about 7 or 8 times I hold the torch, probably.
You don't know, like, how long? Like, was it 2 miles, 3 miles, or a mile, or?
No, nothing like that.
Oh,
I think
okay.
It was about,
that's
I would
cool.
Say, I would say it may have been, I guess, maybe 2 or 3 or 4 or 5 minutes at some occasions.
Oh, wow. That is cool. And then y'all just pass it to the other, your other teammates, the other 10 or 9?
Our law enforcement.
Oh, place. That is awesome. So did y'all actually get to, at the end of it, did y'all light something like they do in the in the Olympics, like where they light the
the
big thing? The what is it called? I don't. Do you know what it's called, Paul?
The cauldron.
Cauldron.
Yeah, when every country we went to, I got to lit the cauldron in France. In Paris, France.
You lit it there?
Yeah, it was awesome.
That is cool. Were you there for that?
I was not.
Oh, that would have been cool. That's neat.
But there are some other cool things. I went to Monaco.
Mm-hmm.
Got to meet Prince Albert. Prince Albert likes racing.
That's cool.
I've been to Spain.
I want to go to Spain.
I've been to Italy.
I want to go there.
Awesome. I want to go there, too.
I've been to Belgium.
Oh, that's cool.
Some dignitaries there. I've been to the United Kingdom.
Uh-huh.
And I've been to Ireland.
That is so awesome. And that's all with Special Olympics. So, you see, this really, I mean, just talking with both of y'all, what were you going to say, Paul?
Oh, nothing.
Oh, I thought you were going to say something. So, this shows everybody out there, you know, how amazing it is to be part of this organization and what an outlet it is. It gets y'all out there and gives you an opportunity to experience the world and see the world. And no matter what, you are able to do things like everybody, and it doesn't make you any different. And I love that. So what does being a part of this organization mean to you?
Well, it's gave me more opportunities than I would have not had if it wasn't for Special Olympics.
Yeah, definitely. So I'm going to ask both of y'all a question. So, you know, with y'all being in Special Olympics and y'all being in this organization, do you feel like that they support y'all with everything that y'all do, and they give you a bit of a self-confidence?
Yes.
Do they teach y'all, like, you know, not to let anybody bring you down no matter what?
Yes.
So would you say anybody out there feeling inferior, you know, if they need it, they should check out this organization?
They should.
Definitely. Mm-hmm. Would y'all have any other, like Jim was asking earlier, y'all's coach, any advice or any words of wisdom or anything that to encourage others out there not to give up and to that this is an outlet for you? Or do y'all have any words of encouragement for people out there? Jonathan?
Well, I would say one thing. The most important thing is once you cross the finish line, you're a winner.
I love that.
In Special Olympics, once you cross that finish line, regardless of what place you get, everybody's a winner.
I love that. Do you have anything, Paul?
Not really.
So what do you, can you, I have something that's totally off the wall, but can you tell us more about China?
Yes.
Tell us, so what was your experience out there? What all did you do? What tell us more.
Like the food, the rice.
What did you do while you were out there?
I did the softball throw and the 100-meter walk.
Awesome. The softball throw, how did you like that?
Pretty good.
Cool. And what else?
The 100-meter walk.
100-meter walk?
Yes.
I don't think I could do that.
Is their rice better or worse than our rice that we make at Thanksgiving?
Do what?
Is their rice better or worse than what we make at Thanksgiving?
It was better, yes.
It was better?
Yeah.
And we just want to also let the audience know to go and check out LISDSO.org. That's Paul's team. And y'all can also go to SOTX to come out and volunteer or get involved with the organization. We're really excited to have y'all here, and we're so thankful that y'all are able to come out here and interview and let everybody know about y'all's organization and the organization y'all represent. Y'all are both spokesmen for Special Olympics, aren't you?
Yes.
That's awesome. What does that mean to you to be a spokesman for this organization?
Go around the community.
You get to go around the community and do what?
And do speeches.
That's awesome. What do you give speeches about?
Our experiences.
Yeah, we give speeches. We talk about what we did in our, like our accomplishments, like the 2003 torch run, like I did.
Mm-hmm.
And, of course, the one I've got now, this Big 12 Special Olympic ring that looks like a Super Bowl Daytona 500 ring.
Mm-hmm.
It's awesome.
That's awesome. So I noticed that the other day I saw a picture of y'all with this check. It's like $6,500 or $6,400. What's that about? The Norma's Cafe? What is that?
They gave us a check. We did we spent half a day there last month.
Doing what?
Walking around tables, saying hello to the customers.
Did you say walking on tables?
No. Walking to tables, that's what I mean.
Oh, okay. Well,
saying hello to the customers.
Oh, y'all were just meeting and greeting people?
Yes.
That's awesome. Jonathan, what did you think of that experience?
Yeah, we've been at Norma's for, let's see, last year we did it. We did the thing that they were donating to us, and mm-hmm. it was awesome. It's been around for a while, since
1956.
Yeah.
Norma's Cafe has?
Yeah. Yes.
And one of them has an old Icy and an old Pegasus, a Mobile One Pegasus, like the Pegasus that you would see in Dallas.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, there's a Pegasus there. It's got a lot of old stuff there, like some of the sponsors that would look like from back in the day, they have them at Norma's. They have all these old pictures of cars too, like Studebakers, Hudsons, and Packers.
That's cool. So I noticed there were a couple of cops in the picture. What's that called? Is it like?
It's called Tip-A-Cop.
Tip-A-Cop.
Tip-A-Cop. Okay, so it's Tip-A-Cop at Norma's.
Yeah.
And something else that we wanted to mention is that this organization, Special Olympics of Texas, it's good for all age groups. And teens also have the ability to learn not to bully when they meet the athletes, which is great. I think that's amazing, you know, not to be bullied and not to bully people, because that's always going on with everybody and people in general. So that's good to learn no matter what. So I think that's amazing.
Didn't Grandma tell you that a kid was getting made fun of, and since he protected himself, he got suspended?
Yes. I mean, there's just a lot of different things that are going on like that where kids are bullied and they defend themselves. But it's how you go about defending yourself. And I think this organization helps you learn how to defend yourself and handle yourself appropriately. We have a caller. Hold on 1 second. You're live on the air with JAR Radio. Who are we talking to and where are you calling from?
This is Paul's Aunt Becky. I have questions for both of the boys.
Hi, Aunt Becky, Mama, a.k.a. Mommy. This is the Meemaw. Everybody knows her as the Meemaw.
Anyway, I was going to ask Paul and Jonathan how many medals they have.
A lot, Aunt Becky.
Yeah,
I know, but have you ever counted them?
I never counted them, no.
Why haven't you counted them?
How many gold ones do you have?
I'm guessing about 40.
40 gold ones?
Oh, my goodness.
Wow, 40 gold medals.
How about you, Jonathan?
I would say about probably 30, three or something like that.
Uh-huh. Tell me, Paul, how many different games have you participated in? I know you've participated in swimming and other things. What are all of the activities that you've done, all different sports?
Recently,
in your 25 years.
Recently, I did the softball throw out in UTA. It was all muddy.
Oh, no.
My shoes were muddy. Everything.
Oh, my goodness. Well, that's Texas right now,
yes,
Paul.
Yes.
But how many different things have you participated in? All the different sports?
I guess about 12 sports, I guess.
How about you, Jonathan?
I would say 8. 2 of them I'm active in, running and golf.
Awesome.
In golf. I love golf.
I used to like be so impatient when it came to golf, but I think now that I've gotten older, that I think I'm ready to learn it. I think that'd probably be soothing, kind of. I don't know. Maybe one of you guys.
So how many different kind of games does Special Olympic represent? How many different sports? Do you know?
Right now, about 20.
About 20 different sports?
20 or 25.
That's awesome.
How can people find out about how many sports or what different sports they have?
Go to the Special Olympics Facebook page, Area 10, which is Greater Dallas.
Awesome.
So different areas have different games?
Yes.
Okay, I understand. Okay, well, thank you, boys. I'm glad to hear y'all on the show.
Oh, thank you, Aunt Becky.
And also, it was your Aunt Becky's idea or thought, because I was like, you know, I want to get somebody on. We haven't had anybody really special on, and she was like, well, what about Paul? He's a spokesman. I was like, you know what?
Yes.
That'll be awesome. So thank you for that, Mom, for bringing. You
You're
know,
welcome.
That was a great
also,
idea.
Also about the bone. I was gonna say the little toes, but I would say now the risk.
Nope, you're wrong. I'm sorry.
Oh, heck. Okay, bye.
Thank you. Bye. And that was the Meemaw calling in. Thank you for calling, Mom. We really appreciate it. My Aunt Lizzie just informed us that there will be a tip-a-cop at the Roadhouse on July 23rd. So everybody can come out to that and check out the boys. Y'all can see them live and talk to them and see how cool they are. They're really amazing. Is it just y'all two, or are there other athletes out there?
There'll be other athletes.
Awesome. About how many of y'all will be out there?
Probably 8 or 10 at different Texas Roadhouse.
Oh, so they're going to be at all different roadhouses?
Yes.
Just in Louisville or everywhere?
We'll be in Flower Mound.
Oh, Flower Mound. Okay. So you two will be at the Flower Mound Roadhouse?
Yes.
Okay, and that's July 23rd, correct?
Yes, you can come out too.
Yeah, that would be cool. So so that's a statewide event that y'all hold, the Tip-A-Cop?
Yes.
Does this go on all the time or just sporadically?
Sporadically, I think.
Oh, okay. Okay.
They do it almost sporadically most of the time. It depends on, like, what the sponsor wants to do a Tip-A-Cop. If it's the Texas Roadhouse or Dunkin' Donuts or some of the other places.
What is it, the Tip-A-Cop? Like, what is that about? I mean, you're tipping a cop?
No, it's to tip a cop to help Special Olympics.
Awesome. Okay, I got it. I'm just trying to make sure I understand and the audience understands, you know, all the different things that are going on with you guys.
Mm-hmm.
So nobody has answered our first question, and we're about to give out another question.
Ooh,
so if nobody answers these questions, these will roll over to the following week. So if I were you, I'd get out my Google or something and find out which human bone is most commonly broken. Call in to 214-556-6239 and give me the answer so you can have a chance to win one of two bikes that are be given away. And we are going to be giving out our next question in a few seconds. Okay, right now we're going to give it out. So the next question is, what food smell is most recognized by people worldwide? Again, the question is, what food smell is most recognized by people worldwide? That's the next question on our trivia for the bike giveaway. So y'all call in and give us the answer for one of these two questions, and you'll have a chance to win the bikes. The first question was, which human bone is most commonly broken? And we gave you a multiple choice. It's either your hand, your collarbone, your wrist, or your hip. Hand, collarbone, wrist, or hip. So y'all go ahead and call in with that answer. And we're going to take a quick break. And when we come back, we're going to talk a little more to the guys up in here. And we're going to get a little more information out there about Special Olympics.
You are back with JARR Radio on Fishbowl Radio Network.
Thank you for tuning in. We just got done interviewing two amazing young gentlemen, Paul Holland. Hi, Paul.
Hi, Regina. How are you?
I'm great. Thank you. And Jonathan Blackmon. How are you, Jonathan?
I'm good.
Great. We just got done interviewing them and talking to them about Special Olympics of Texas and how we can get involved and the amazing things that they've had the opportunity to do. And the fact that it makes it possible for mean teens to understand how to care for people and how not to be bullying the athletes, and for everybody to have confidence and be kind to each other and all that good stuff. And this is an organization that caters to all age groups, and you can go and learn more about the organization at LISDSO.org. Or you can go to SOTX.org to find out more information about this organization. And they're also on Facebook and on Twitter. So y'all might want to go check that out. Also, we were talking about Tip a Cop, which is a cool way to raise funds for the organization at various restaurants and places. Where they just actually raised $6,400 at Norma's Cafe recently. And the next event is going to be on July 23rd at Roadhouse in Flower Mound and throughout Texas. So that's kind of cool to know about. Also, I was told, Paul, that you were on the state board, SMT.
Yes.
And, well, what do they do?
Like give sports rules.
They do what?
We got a caller.
We talk about ideas where the state games should go in the future.
Okay, so do they talk about, hold on 1 second, we have a caller. JARR Radio, you're live on the air. Who's calling and where are you calling from?
It's the Meemaw again.
The Meemaw. Okay, and just...
It's a cookie.
What?
Cookies, the smell?
Cookies, no.
Oh, heck. Okay, bye.
Grandma, you got a guest right.
You. Oh, and you know what? Speaking of, when we left, right before we left, we had the laughing Aunt Lizzie on the phone. And she and she said the answer was collarbone, and that is actually correct. I don't know what I was looking at, but the answer to the trivia question, which human bone is most commonly broken, the answer is collarbone. Most sustained from athletic injuries. So congratulations to Liz Holland. We'll be posting that soon. And yep, that was answered correctly. So moving forward, where were we talking about right before? Yeah, the SMT. So they make rules for the athlete games and stuff.
Yes.
Okay, that's kind of cool, Paul. How long have you been on the board?
This is my third year.
3 years?
Yeah.
Are you on the board?
No.
Not at this time? Okay.
No, I'm in with the torch run.
You'll make
the
it.
The torch run. Okay. Awesome. Yeah, y'all do different things, so you are involved with different parts of the organization, now, correct?
Yes. With the calls, I mean, with the...
We have another caller, guys. Let's get it. Hold on 1 second. JARR Radio, you're live on the air. Who's calling and where are you calling from?
Connie Gangloss.
Hi, Connie. Did you have a question for our gentleman, or you want to shout out to them?
Yes, I have a question.
Okay, go ahead.
I wanted them to elaborate. I know there are two golf tournaments that they're involved in locally there in their area, and I wanted them to give a shout out for those and tell people about it.
Okay. Who wants to go? Who wants to elaborate on that for? Jonathan's giving you the look, Paul Edward.
Recently.
Can you, ma'am? Do you mind turning down your radio?
Oh, sorry.
Okay. Thank you so much for turning that down, because it was just like going back into the feed. So we have a caller on the line that can't, hold on 1 second. Go ahead. Do you mind repeating your question, ma'am?
Well, to answer the question, that is the Louisville ISD Special Olympics largest fundraiser of the year. We have over 200 athletes, and that's how we get our money to take our athletes to our state games. It's held on the last Monday of every September, and we have 288 golfers.
That's amazing. That's cool.
And I'm the one that gives the command, ladies and gentlemen, start your golf carts.
That's true.
That's cool.
And it will be our 21st golf tournament this coming September. And we have a gentleman that has been a longtime volunteer, Mr. Joe Kushar, also has a small mini two golf challenge in May of every year. And you can, of course, go look at our website, LISDSO.org, to get any information. Thank you for the call.
Yeah, but it'll be also at Indian Creek.
Awesome. Thank you so much. And that was Liz Holland representing the Special Olympics of Texas. That's my auntie, the Laughing Ant. I'm just playing. You know what? Our family has fun. We're always laughing, and I like to say that most of us are always having a good time and, you know, enjoying each other, and I'm very blessed with that. And I'm so blessed to be able to have had y'all on the air with us today. It's really exciting. And y'all have given us a plethora of information, which I'm thankful for, about this amazing organization. That was your aunt.
Yeah,
Jonathan?
That was my Aunt Connie, yeah.
Oh, well, say shout out to your aunt. Say shout out, Aunt Connie.
Thanks, Aunt Connie, for calling.
Yes, thank you, Aunt Connie, for calling in and supporting us and supporting these gentlemen in their representation of Special Olympics of Texas. And so you're on the Torch Run Area Committee, is that correct?
Yep.
And so... what is it? She's from Houston.
The Woodlands.
Yeah, the Woodlands. That's
oh,
where she
the
lives.
Woodlands. Oh, that's cool. That is cool. So, the Torch Run, the area committee, what does it do? It's police officers that raise money for y'all. Is that correct?
Yep.
Awesome. So it's like Tip a Cop. So it's like police officers are helping y'all out with raising money for the Special Olympics.
Yes.
Is that correct? Am
yes.
I understanding correct?
Yep. Yes.
Okay, I'm just making sure I'm understanding correct, so our audience is also understanding correct. So all y'all out there, y'all get involved. Y'all check out the website. Again, that website is LISDSO.org. Or you can go to SOTX.org and find out how you can get involved with the Special Olympics in your area, because this is worldwide. Am I correct?
Yes.
I mean, it's actually international. That's how these young gentlemen have been able to travel all over the world with the organization. And y'all go and y'all can donate. Y'all can go and check out the Roadhouse on July 23rd with the Tip-A-Cop committee.
Yes.
And raise money for the Special Olympics of Texas, and y'all jump in and help out and do something that you know, if you're looking for an organization to participate in and help and volunteer with, this is a great organization. So we really appreciate again y'all being here. We are coming coming to a close on the show. So are there any last words or any last thoughts? I know Paul, you had a cool did you know fact. Why don't you give us that did you know fact before we leave?
Okay, Oscar the Grouch was orange.
That what?
Oscar the Grouch was orange.
Oh, well, that's cool. How did you find that out? Oscar Grouch was orange.
Watch it on YouTube.
Awesome. So what color is he now?
Green. He's green.
He's green. That's how I know Oscar the Grouch. Did you have anything?
Well, let's see. This past week at the it was at Dover International Speedway, FedEx 400, Jimmy Johnson won the race.
That is cool. Is he one of your faves?
No, there's people that like him, but there's a lot of people who don't like him because he's won six championships. He won five championships in a row in 2006 and 2010.
Well, you can't help, he's that good. So I was also, I forgot, we need to also mention the fact that there is on June 25th, the Torch Runners will be running with the Torch for the SO World Games.
In Los Angeles.
In Los Angeles, that's cool. Y'all need to check out, everybody out there, y'all check out the website for more information. It's said to be really awesome and amazing. Again, that's June 25th. The Torch Runners will be running with the Torch for the SO World Games, Special Olympics World Games. So y'all can check out the website for more information on that. That is really cool, and we're so blessed and honored to have two amazing, impressive international athletes in the house. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Y'all have been a pleasure. Yeah, y'all have been a pleasure to have on the air with us. And
we should do this again.
Yeah, well, maybe we can, and we can find out more information.
I'll probably talk about Special Olympics, but I'll probably talk about racing too and cars.
Oh, yeah, that'll be cool. You know what? I know somebody else that has a show on here that does nothing but sports and racing and all that stuff. He might like to have y'all on the air, too. Mm-hmm. Y'all would probably really enjoy that. That's Taman Turner. He has a show on Fridays. Y'all might want to tune into that. Y'all check that out. My Aunt Lizzie is saying that they will be in Dallas June 25th. That's what we said, right?
Yes.
Yeah, we said it right. We got it right. So anyhow, we're going to, like we said, we're going to go ahead and close the show. Next week, we are going to be talking to the fabulous, cutest little girl. She'll be calling in. Her name is Audrey. She's a representative. She has DBA, which is Diamond Black Anemia, Blackmon Anemia, and she is precious. She's like 6 years old. She has a Facebook page, and they post like all these different videos of her doing Zumba and just dancing. This little girl is so precious. We are so in love with her, and we're so excited to be talking to her father and hopefully her too. Next week they're going to be calling in, and we're excited about that. And we have a whole bunch more to come up. We have Cassie Cole calling, coming in the studio soon to talk about DFW Teen Fashion Week, and we have a whole bunch coming up. So y'all make sure to tune in every week on Tuesday from 5 to 7 in the Gray Bowl to JAR Radio, and listen to us, check us out, see what we have going on, because we are always promoting you, and that's what we're here to do. So with that, remember, you can do all things through Christ who strengthens you, and y'all stay tuned. Have a great week. Thank you so much.